She is now 42 years old and serving the longest sentence of any woman housed at the maximum security Bedford Hills Correctional Facility in New York. Life without the possibility of parole.
If I could gather up the people who feel most strongly against me, that's probably who I'm talking to right now.
She says she wants the people of New Hampshire to have a conversation about the crime, the trial, and her sentence.
I'm so much more than the worst mistake of my life. And I feel like I've been frozen in time inside that mistake to get involved with Bill. And I have never been able to get out of it.
It was 1990. Billy Flynn was 15. She was a 22-year-old media coordinator for Winnicunnet High School. She admits to the affair but says she did not mastermind the murder of her husband. Greg Smart was shot inside their Derry condo.
I said, God forgive me.
Flynn, three other teens, and Pam Smart were arrested.
Billy Flynn admitted to killing your husband.
Yes.
He and the other teens charged insist that you planned the murder.
Right.
Did you?
No, I did not. I did never wanted Greg killed. I never wanted him to kill Greg. I never asked him to. I never insinuated that I wanted him to kill my husband.
She insists the teens lied to get a plea bargain and that media coverage swayed the jury.
They'll be leaving prison. And right now, as it stands, I won't be. So I believe there's obvious motivation for why they said what they said.
William Flynn and Patrick Randall won sentence reductions and are eligible for release in 2015. Raymond Fowler and Vance Latimy Jr. were already paroled.
I think if I could talk to the people in New Hampshire, I would also tell them not to try to understand that I'm so much more than just the one horrible thing that people have judged me by. And that was my relationship with Bill Flynn and everything that happened after it.
She says she's not the Pam Smart most people think they know.
I'm not like a movie caricature. I'm not this image, this character in a show. I'm a real human being that does feel and feels deeply sorry for what happened.
Pam Smart's request for a pardon hearing was denied in 2005. She says she will try to have her sentence reduced in the future. On News 9 tonight at 11, our one-on-one continues. After 20 years, what Pam Smart wants people in New Hampshire to have a conversation about. Jean Mackin, WMUR, News 9.